All right, so today in the Northeast, just windy, no storms, but plain old winds that actually could do some damage like severe thunderstorms do. Weather definitely playing a part in that. Plus, it gets cold, too. So let me talk about these temperatures behind that noun, that town name, Hurricane Mills.
Yeah, exactly. We should Google that.
All right, now coming up here, we want to talk more about what's happening in the Northeast, because just as ice is breaking high on Thursday, though, that's brutal,
too. I know,
that's
brutal.
Now, an ice jam shut off water to Niagara Falls, causing the attraction to run dry on this day in 1848. Coming up next on AMHQ Monday, icy temperatures. A lot of people are getting... It is Monday. We're thankful that you are here, chose to get up with us for this early edition of America's Morning Headquarters. I'm meteorologist Jen Carfagno. It is the final Monday in March.
Yes, we are moving like a... What is it, a steam train?
Yeah, we're going fast.
A train.
Like the Acela. Like we're going fast.
Yes. I'm meteorologist Jordan Steele. So the calendar may say spring, as I say we're moving forward. However, we're going to kind of rewind it a little bit because Mother Nature is still kicking around winter in some places. Others are hoping to get a few days to rest after another round of devastating and deadly weather as well.
Storms, and you had the flooding. Then this weekend, well, certainly here in Middle Tennessee, we got the brunt of it. You can see that corridor of really heavy rainfall. I mean, anywhere from 4 to 8 inches of rain fell across this area in the Nashville area, our second wettest two-day period on record. And so much of it really came down in just a couple of hours. So here are some of the rainfall totals. We can show you the area's hardest hit. It was actually just south of Nashville in this corridor from, you know, it was southwestern Tennessee right up through the northeastern part of the state there, and then up into Kentucky, where we saw the biggest rainfall. So here are the numbers. The one-day total, 5.75. So again, a lot of this fell just on either side of midnight in a couple of hours. 5.75 for March 27th. That was Saturday here, and that is now our fourth wettest March day on record. All right, so let me show you where we're still dealing with issues. The purple, we still have major flooding. The red, we still have moderate flooding. And in the orange, we still have minor flooding. Now, you know how it is in a flash flood situation. Everything jumps up really quick, especially streams and creeks. But then the rivers take a while to go up, and then they take a little bit longer to come down as well. So here's the Harpeth River at Bellevue, and it is still up here in some flooding, some moderate flooding, but we are going to be, some minor flooding. We're going to see it coming down here throughout the day today, getting back down below action stage. But, you know, for now, Jordan, there's still a lot to deal with.
I know. It was such a busy.
Yeah. And that's the nicest way we could say. I mean, you have such a week ahead of you weather-wise here. Look at our winds right now, gusting to 44 miles per hour. Yes, those are snow showers flying around. Our temperatures are sitting in the mid-30s, but it was snowing in Buffalo this morning. Flakes are flying around Syracuse and Binghamton, and again, Albany area, even though at the airport right now, not officially. I know you look out your window, and there's probably a flake or two flying. It's just moving too fast, right, to be captured. Look at Berlin and New Hampshire. We've got 38 degrees, and we've got some snow showers flying around. And so this system, cold air is blasting in, or colder air, I should say, compared to what we had over the weekend. And it's going to be so windy today in the wake of the system coming on through. So that's going to be, I think, your biggest challenge is that if it was trash day, you put your trash can out last night, you're going to have to walk down to the end of the block to get it because the winds are going to take it. We've got strong winds through the day, and the kind of wind, actually, more seriously than your trash can, could knock out power. So make sure you keep everything charged up here. You're going to be watching right through at least 4 or 5 o'clock these winds. Most of the wind advisories do expire at about 4 o'clock, and things will calm down for this evening. Happened as we get you out there today. It has been all kinds of wild stuff, right? Today it's all about the wind. The wind has changed direction now, coming from the west and the northwest. Here we've got the front all the way through, gusting in Albany to 44 miles per hour. Buffalo were gusting to nearly 25, and New York City gusting to nearly 40. What a windy day behind this system, and also behind this front that came through. We got some snow showers that are flying around out here. Probably not enough to create any major travel issues. Temperatures are in the mid-30s. Road temperatures are warmer, but we'll keep an eye on things. And it definitely is going to be disruptive, right? It's going to be affecting your visibility for sure. With winds 40 to 50 miles per hour through the day today, blowing around those snow showers. Jordan, you just, you know, can't see, or you're distracted.
Yeah, just be careful throughout the day today, you guys.
The end of the week, but hey, there's snowflakes flying around right now out here. Syracuse saw some snowflakes. Buffalo saw some snowflakes. Albany, we could see it. Plus, the wind is just so strong. High wind warnings and advisories are up all across this area. They go till about 4 or 5 o'clock today, and we're already gusting. 44 in Albany, New York City gusting to nearly 40. Boston, we're gusting above 30 miles per hour. So it's everywhere with this wind. It's not like it's one little corridor. Very windy day. Yes, the snowflakes are flying around. Most of them not really productive and sticking too much. But, I mean, look, we're down to 31 in Binghamton, so you can get a new coating of snow out here, and it is snowing. We've got snow in Berlin and New Hampshire. Hampshire as well, 37, a little bit warmer. And it was a warm weekend, right? So road temperatures, luckily, are in pretty good shape. So let's take a look at what plays out through today. The concern with these winds is that we could have a lot of power outages because it's only going to get worse before it gets better. Already, we've got more than 135,000 power outages across the country, Maine, New Hampshire, Connecticut, Massachusetts, New York. You guys all leading the list here when it comes to people without power. Keep everything charged up today because you never know when you might lose power and you might not be able to charge your phone for a while. You have to go in your car, right? We've got today winds 40, 50. Albany, Portland will be up there over 40 miles per hour right through the lunch hour. Look at Providence. We're gusting that strong. And it's a west wind. So it's going to be a crosswind pretty much on 95, on 93, 81, 83. All of these here north-south interstates are going to be the ones that really feel, I think, the strongest crosswind, making it tough for travelers, Jordan.
Yeah, and you guys are going to...
As well, a lot of red flag warnings. These are the wind advisories and high wind warnings that are posted. The bright purple, look at all this high wind warning that is out there. And this is going to be a really strong 50, 60 mile per hour wind for a lot of the day. What a windy day. The kind of day when you go outside and you just take a breath and you just get a mouthful of dust, right? Because it's that windy and it's that dry too. That's why the red flag warnings are up all the way down the central plains. I mean, from North Dakota straight down into Texas. Look at this. We got a red flag warning. And that's because the ground is dry, the air is dry and getting dried out more by all of this wind blowing around. Montana, Wyoming, you guys are going to feel the worst of the wind first. In fact, that's happening right now through the afternoon. It starts to blow in here across portions of North and South Dakota. 50, 60 mile per hour winds, Bismarck, Rapid City. And so it's mainly a west or northwest wind that's going to be your strongest wind. But these south winds here, no joke either. I mean, look at this. Wichita, 40 to 50 today coming out of the south. And there's a front in here that's going to be blasting through. And all that happens is the wind just changes direction, Jordan.
Yeah. All right, so you guys have heard.
So let me show you what's coming our way. Tuesday's forecast goes up to 70. Nice and sunny, beautiful day. Friday morning, you're starting off at freezing. This is why you don't plant till after tax day in the south, because yes, it can still get cold. It's actually not that unusual, but here comes a strong front that does make it all the way down through the Gulf Coast. So temperatures dropping off, going below average. By Friday morning, we may be setting some record cold readings, actually, for some of you. Temperatures 10 to 25 degrees below average. It's that 25 below average that really, I think, pushes you closer to record territory. All right, so today, we have temperatures starting off on a chilly note, actually. A lot of 30s and 40s out there, but really quickly rebounding. You're going to be into the 70s tomorrow afternoon in Nashville, Montgomery, Atlanta will stay in the 60s, but for the most part, you're in the 70s. Then we watch this front approach. Look at 5 o'clock here on your Wednesday. Here it comes. 5 o'clock in the afternoon, you're 46 degrees in Nashville. Yes, that is a faux pas that we got coming on through. Here comes the front. Temperatures on Thursday afternoon, Atlanta into the 50s as well. Get you into Friday, and we're going to see morning lows in the 30s or below. Look at Nashville. I bet you those spots that do drop into the 20s, Jordan.
Did Jen just...
Back in some of the same areas, plus severe weather. So the south drying out today, that's key, right? After all the weekend, heavy rain, and of course, that rain falling on homes covered by tarps following last week's tornadoes. And coming up, not nearly the rainfall totals that Nashville saw, but still we had, you know, 3/4 of an inch of rain around Birmingham. Fortunately, a new front, though, does bring in the threat of severe weather and heavy rain back to the Mid-South on Tuesday afternoon. So that's what I want to talk about. Let's get into this forecast here and show you what we are going to find. First, some of the areas that did see severe weather over the weekend. We had a couple of tornadoes in Tennessee, one around Decatur, one in Hendersonville County, and we had some back into Louisiana, also into Texas. There was one cell in particular I was watching from Louisiana right up through Arkansas, and then it just became a big rain story, right? Now, today we get the sunshine out there. We're going to keep it nice and dry today and for most of tomorrow, but then things do evolve yet again. So here comes our next system. There's a lot of energy coming into the northwest. There's the front that drops down, and as we see this big trough dig in, we again have a front that's going to pull up more moisture from the Gulf of Mexico, and that is going to bring another rain situation for us here. Can't call it anything else right now, considering just how saturated everything is, how high the streams and creeks and rivers are across this area. So here comes Tuesday night. Here comes the front. Moisture in place that is going to lead to some thunderstorms. We could see severe weather here. It's possible that hail, damaging winds could happen with any of these little cells that pop here. It's not a huge outbreak, not like the event that we saw last week for sure, but definitely, look, it's late March, so any of these storms could fire up and have that potential to bring some strong damaging winds or some small hail, maybe some damaging hail across this area. But then the rainfall, and we've got rainfall that could be heavy at times, again, across western Tennessee, middle Tennessee, Nashville's in it, Memphis is in it, Jackson, Tennessee is in it, and we'll have to watch for that risk of flooding. Now, the South does get sunshine today to clean up both flood and tornado damage. Preliminary assessments indicate 33 reported tornadoes struck on Thursday, then another 18 on Saturday, for a total of 51. New this morning, people are digging through wreckage in hard-hit Alabama, trying to find pieces of lives interrupted. Governor Brian Kemp getting a look at destruction in Atlanta's southern suburbs on Saturday. The tornado that ripped into Noonan is only the 10th EF4 in Georgia, dating back to 1950. Storms this week, Jim, but thankfully not like last week.
Yeah, this is not. It's going to be cold.
Especially in the overnight.
Especially during
the overnight. You're not going to want that sunrise sort of walk by the beach, let me tell you, in the morning.
Unless you're prepared for it.
Well, that's true.
So let's talk about that. I mean, this is a pretty significant trough. I mean, the good news, let's start with the good, because I always like the good.
Yeah.
We're going to shut off the faucet in the southeast for a few days.
For severe weather, yeah.
For severe weather and heavy rainfall.
Right.
So.
Yeah, we do have a little bit to get through, but then let's talk temperature side of things.
Yeah, it's the bad news.
Yeah. All right. So, it's really warm out ahead of the front. It's going to be warm and windy, though. You don't really get to take advantage of it.
No, you won't. Yeah. I mean, we got a couple of mild days, and that's what we've been dealing with for several weeks now, so it's going to be harder to go back.
Yeah.
Because we're going back a month and a half.
The thing is, below average now is not as bad as it was, like, back in February.
True.
Which is true, right? But once you get used to these spring temperatures, it's hard to go back.
So think about it. You go to your favorite nursery.
Yeah.
Or you go to the store and you think, all these beautiful spring and summer plants. You're like, I got to have some.
Yeah.
I got to put them in my yard.
Not here.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
You got to cover them if you've put them in, because we're talking about freezing temperatures coming up this weekend.
Yes, and we could see some record low temperatures,
actually.
Yeah,
that's a good point.
All right, so Panama City, here's what we're going to be the next 2 days. Mid to upper 70s. I mean, look at that. It's perfect, right? Get ready for Friday morning. 42 degrees.
42 degrees.
Yeah.
Find a nice spot out of the wind. The other thing, too, is this is going to be a windy system for about a day and a half.
It's going to be brisk.
So there'll be wind chill factor involved in through here. So here's another one here for you. We've got Daytona Beach. Could we go from the 80s down to the 50s? Barely 50.
Barely 50 for those morning low temperatures. All right, so places like Atlanta, Charlotte, Birmingham, Nashville. Last year, our last freeze of the season was so much earlier than this year.
I know, right?
But earlier than average, too. So you can't get used to that.
It'll be interesting to see how the flush out and all the foliage helps maybe keep the temperature up maybe a degree or two. We'll
see. Thing, though, if everything's in bloom, I feel like, you know, a cool, crisp night sort of lets it hang on a little bit longer. Right?
Yeah,
sometimes.
That's true.
And so it's easier to extend the flowers, right? Atlanta area, 69 degrees for you today. 32, though, by Friday morning.
32 degrees. In North Georgia, could be some teens, believe it or not, as some of the guidance says. Yeah. All right. How about that stuff?
Oh, boy. All right. So, you know what? Most of the day is not going to be at 60 mile per hour winds here either, but it could get that strong. That's crazy, right? 60 mile per hour winds. We're talking about that across a large portion of the east. And we've already been at 44 for more than an hour here in Albany in New York. Plus, it's snowing. I mean, oh, come on, right? That's what you're saying? Just wait to see the forecast later this week. Snow showers are flying around. Most of them not that productive. I think some of these probably are up across northern part of Vermont, you know, putting down just a little extra snow this morning. Winds are so strong, though, blowing everything around. Now we're gusting to 41 in Albany, 37 in New York City, and Boston 35. So this is the kind of wind that could knock down tree limbs, knock out power. We've seen it already. You might have a lot of those traffic lights that are blinking, or maybe nothing this morning. So just be ready to treat everything as a four-way if you don't have the traffic lights going, because it is going to be, I think, a tough day. The winds don't calm down until after about 4 or 5 o'clock this afternoon. Albany, 40 to 50 mile per hour winds. Providence and Rhode Island, we're going to see the same kind of winds too. And it's a west wind, so it's a crosswind. If you're traveling 95, you will just feel it buffeting your car. Slowing down actually is the only thing that can make a difference. I mean, and it's tough with winds like this, Steph.
That it is. Along with meteorologist Jim Cantore and Jen Carfagno, we're going to outline not only another stormy week, but a snowy week, believe it or not, for some of you. But first, we want to start with this ongoing situation in Tennessee. The Nashville Fire Department conducting 130 rescues over the weekend as fast-moving water overtook roads across the city. More than 2,400 calls were made to 911 in just 6 hours. We want to show you why that is here and what we dealt with here over the weekend. And there were numerous reports here of all types of severe weather, from tornadoes to wind to hail, and also flooding as well. These are our local storm reports in Tennessee. And as we zoom on into Nashville, we can show you the heavy rain that blew on through. This is on Saturday. You see Saturday evening, as we made our way overnight and into Sunday morning, that rain continued. And we saw record-setting rain, as a matter of fact, here. Some spots south of the city. Notice the red. That red on our legend is 8+ inches of rain. Officially in Nashville, we had our wettest March day, our fourth wettest day overall. By the way, 5.75 is what we got on Saturday. You know, our March average is 4.11 inches for the entire month. We saw more than that in just a matter of a day, and that, of course, is keeping our rivers high here in and around Tennessee. Let's now head to Nashville. That's where the Weather Channel's Justin Michaels has been over the weekend, and he joins us this morning. Justin, for those of us that are just catching up, how did this all play out over the weekend, and how did the residents react?
Right,
in a second. It's a Monday.
Crazy stuff.
Happy Monday, everyone, and we'll get into that cold air because I agree with Jim. I think that actually will be what grabs all the headlines as we head into the week. So here's a look at the rain as we head through Tuesday evening. Rain is returning to the south. Tuesday into our Wednesday, all across Tennessee, places that don't need to see it. Lawrenceburg to Murfreesboro to McMinnville, all the way to Dayton. We are going to see more rain. Not great news for the rivers. This is going to make them slow down a little bit. We have that forecast for you momentarily. But here are some of those storms that, you know, Jim was kind of alluding to. Not a severe weather outbreak, but the possibility of some of those thunderstorms. And then, of course, that threat for flooding here. Look on the spine of the Appalachians. Everything's going to move east. You see that cold air with the rain, snow mixing in for us behind it. That cold air gets all the way down into really the I-10 corridor. Here are those rivers I was mentioning. Duck River near Hurricane Mills really takes until Wednesday to get down to minor flood stage, and we do not need this 1 to 2 inches. Places like Huntsville, Alabama, we are 5 inches above average. Rome, Georgia, over 4 inches above average, and that's due to this, Jen. Over the last 7 days, it has been nonstop.
I want to learn the story.
The wind, that's what we're going to be dealing with in the recovery in the south. Tuesday is take a walk in the park day. So who has good weather for that? Well, those of you in the northeast, and you also aren't dealing with that pollen just yet. Maybe on Tuesday in the south, you get on the treadmill and you have, you know, now they have scenes that you can run through and spin through. You could do that. On Wednesday, National Crayon Day. I know this controversy between crayon and crayon. It's the East Coast that will be getting wet. And then as we head into our Thursday, things wrap up with snow on the backside of this. Friday into Saturday. Holy mackerel. Look how gorgeous it is across the entire country. And Sunday is actually Vitamin C Day, National Vitamin C Day. You can have C's and D's. Music City got rocked over the weekend as powerful storms pounded Nashville. Torrential rains, we're talking more than 7 inches. They typically get just over 4 for the entire month, Jim.
Yeah, and this has been after a wet month already.
Yeah, on top
this
of
left, you know, streets, homes, businesses all underwater here. Nashville's first responders actually spent the weekend hard at work performing, listen to this, more than 150 rescues. Mm. All right, and it wasn't just the people who had to be led to safer and higher ground. Here you see a farmer helping the cattle, yeah, escaping the rising waters in through here. They don't, last time I checked, they didn't swim.
No.
Cattle, right?
No, they don't. And so thankfully, they got them out to safely. Right. Of course, meteorologist Justin Michaels has been live in Nashville through the weekend and also this morning. He is there for us. And Justin, is this water receding slow or fast? My heart breaks for all these people. So many people are now facing the long and difficult task of, as she was mentioning, cleaning and rebuilding. But as she says, she survived. Georgia Governor Brian Kemp declared a state of emergency for the area over the weekend, deploying numerous agencies to help. Noonan High School, which was heavily damaged in the tornado, will not hold classes virtually or in person this week to give staff and students and family time to focus on recovery. And the other thing I was thinking about there, she was mentioning those trees. I'm sure some of those trees are hundreds of years old, you know. And then that whole process, too, just for the ecosystem to rebuild. Unfortunately, we are running above average when it comes to tornadoes so far this year. And if we look at March, it's been quite a busy month. This is the reports of damaging winds, hail, and tornadoes. And really, as we get into April and May, that's when the season really ramps up. So I don't like that we're already seeing so much damage and so many tornadoes. Our total tornadoes, 164. We are going to see that tick up, Jim, unfortunately, as we head into April. I mean, you see how things just shoot up here over the next couple of months, typically.
Those are the bigger months.
Right there. Okay, let's now talk about what we're going to be dealing with weather-wise. We're going to get a big dip in the jet stream. That means cold air can actually go all the way down to the south. This does not stop in the Midwest, goes to the south. With a low pressure and moisture being tossed over that cold air, you're going to get snow. So let's talk about where we're going to see it. It really cranks as we head into our Wednesday is when we'll see a better chance for that snow. Places like Syracuse, we are 4 feet below average. Erie, we are 3 feet below average. Charleston, Huntington, West Virginia, 11 inches below average here. And we're going to get snow. We're not going to make up these deficits. Burlington, 16 inches below average, while Pittsburgh is almost 16 inches above average. So we are going to be adding to those totals here. Look at that, 8 to 12 inches. We're not going to be able to wipe out our deficits into places like Buffalo, Syracuse, those areas. But we're going to make a nice little dent here. Both models giving us big snow, guys.
So even though the lakes were wide open most
of
the year.
That's true, Jen. You're right. Yeah. April 1st, Thursday.
Yeah, even the lakes were open most of the year, they couldn't make up that snow.
No, they couldn't.
Because that's one of the reasons.